I'm Justine Wilkinson. I'm the programme leader for the MSc in Environmental Health at Northumbria University. We deliver the Chartered Institute for Environmental Health curriculum in Environmental Health, which means that we cover all of the components that you need to cover the academic side if you want to go on to become an Environmental Health practitioner. The first two semesters are sort of covering those core sort of areas. So we cover food safety management, health and safety, risk management, environmental protection and health, housing and health, and also public health. And the final semester, they do an independent piece of research with the supervisor that then becomes their dissertation. The teaching team that we have at Northumbria have all worked in professional practice, and I think that's one of our key sort of selling points, if you like, that we've all got practical skills, we've all been out in the field, whether that be in local government and doing regulatory enforcement work, working for government agencies or working in the private sector, and we bring those practical experiences to the classroom, so it really tries to, I suppose, bring the theory to life. A lot of our students go into the field of environmental health. Some will work with the professional body, which is the Chartered Institute of Environmental Health, and complete their additional assessments to become a fully formed environmental health practitioner. Others go into environmental health work without going down that route. Our students get jobs in a range of different sectors. So the traditional route would be in local government, doing regulatory compliance and risk work. Some students go into work and around sort of policy and strategy work, so for example, contaminated land or flood management. And some students go into the private sector. The environmental health degree and also the Chartered Institute of Environmental Health are internationally recognisable, so our students can also sort of seek employment internationally, particularly with countries that have similar legal frameworks to the UK. So for example, Canada or Australia are particularly sort of aligned in with our regulatory system.